Well, praise the Lord. God bless you. It's so good to hear from you and to see you today and to know that you're viewing the program. We're so excited to come to your home today, but I have a question that I really want to ask you. Do you have desires and dreams and visions in your heart that you really want to come to pass? And you wonder if anybody cares about them? Do anybody care other than you that those things happen? Well, we're going to show you from the Word of God today that God really cares about your desires and the things of your heart.
You know, I have desires too, and this message that we're going to talk about today will help you with the scripture concerning your desires that God said that you can have. So we bless you today, and we thank you for tuning in. So stay tuned, and we'll be right back.
We're connected to this world through our senses, by what's tangible and easy to comprehend. Days when it seems we're going nowhere fast.
Trust your faith to show you the truth. My status is changing, there's no more decline. I'm on my way to better days.
Can you say that?
The status is changing,
and there's no more decline. I'm on my way.
We're connected to this world through our senses, by what's tangible and easy to comprehend.
There are days
when it seems we're going nowhere fast.
Trust your faith to show you the truth.
Give a listen to what faith says to you.
Come on, tell them, Tanisha.
Ooh, my status is changing, there's no more decline, I'm on my way to better days. Oh, my status is changing, there's no more decline, I'm on my way to better days.
Can we declare that tonight?
My status is changing, and there's no more.
Well, I trust you have your Bibles and pens with you right now as we prepare to go into the Word of God. And we talked earlier, I mentioned to you about desires. These are the things we're going to talk about today. And I'm going to tell you something. God has placed desires in your heart. He has given you dreams and things you want. And a lot of us have things that we want. Your desire or your dream may not be mine, but all of us have something that we're anticipating on having, things we're expecting from God, and also for God to do to us and with us, because God wants you to enjoy your life. He wants you to be happy. He wants you to have a fulfilled life, and he doesn't want you sitting around saying maybe it's all over, things are just down and we have nothing to look forward to, it's all doom and gloom. That's not what he came for us to have. Mm-hmm. He came for us to have a good life, a wonderful life, and we're going to talk about that today. Mm-hmm. I mean, and also things you desire. God is concerned about what you want. Mm-hmm. A lot of times we'll say, well, I want what the Lord wants. Well, he know you want what he wants, but also right. He asking you at the same time, what do you want? What do you want?
That's right. And all of us have desires. All of us have wants.
Yes.
You know, but God wants to come to him. Let him know, you know, what you desire. You know, just don't think and say, well, he already know, because he know what's in my mind anyway. But just tell him, ask him.
Let him know.
Yeah, let him know. Right.
Because, you know, it's a two-sided relationship. It's not always about what he wants. That's right. Also, he's concerned about what you want. Mm-hmm. And if you're in a relationship, it should be mutual. It should be a partnership. Right. And he's our father, and he mm-hmm. cares about our desires and things that you want in your own life. And if they are wrong, of course, you know, God will show you that. But mm-hmm. we're going to take you through the Word of God today, because I have dreams and mm-hmm. I have desires. And there are some things I like to do, places I like to go. I mean, I just enjoy in my life.
That's right.
And that's what Christ wants mm-hmm. us to do. And, you know, Sugar, we're going to come from the scriptures here, but I may take a little side excursion here. Okay. In St. John's Gospel, chapter 10, I like how the Amplified talks about mm-hmm. it, but I'm going to read here in St. John 10, and 10:10, and then I want you to read it in the Amplified. And the King James says, St. John 10:10, the thief cometh not, mm-hmm. but for to steal and to kill and to destroy. I am come that they may have life, and that they may have it more abundantly. Mm-hmm. So he said, I came that you may have. Just that's looking right. at that part. So have means to be supplied for. Mm-hmm. I didn't come that you wouldn't lack. I came that you might have. Mm-hmm. Have, and here have life, and have it more abundantly. Mm-hmm. So our God that we serve is the abundant God. He's a lavish God. He always go over and above what you ask or think.
That's right. Because he comes, he wants to enjoy life, you know, and have a good time in life. And what we do in life, and that we, you know, we always please him and thank him. But enjoy life. Have a good time, you know.
Mm-hmm.
You want to, you know, take pleasure in it.
Yes, he does. Mm-hmm. That's his plan.
Take pleasure in what you're doing and be happy.
And be happy with it.
Yeah,
and be happy with it. Mm-hmm. And the Amplified, what is the Amplified saying in St. John 10:10?
The Amplified is saying, the thief comes only in order to steal and kill and destroy. He said, I come that they might have and enjoy life, and have it in abundance to the full till it overflows. So he wants us to have it in abundance.
Mm-hmm.
He wants us to have it full till it overflows.
Yes.
That's right. So it never runs out. We always, you
runs
know,
life. Mm-hmm. Not like the part which says to enjoy.
Enjoy, right.
I want you to enjoy life. Because mm-hmm. a lot of times Christians, people, they think because we're Christian, we shouldn't enjoy ourselves.
Right.
We shouldn't enjoy it. So, Pastor Don, well, I'm going on the church bus trip and I'm going on a picnic and all that. That's okay, but that's more to it than just that.
There's more to it, right.
He said, life does not just consist in the side of a building,
right?
You know, or your surroundings. God has created mm-hmm. a beautiful earth. I mean, the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof,
mm-hmm.
you know, and they that dwell therein.
Right.
So this earth is a beautiful place. Creation is beautiful. And God wants you to enjoy it. He wants you to enjoy the things of the earth that he created for you as a child of God.
Mm-hmm.
And he wants you to enjoy everything he has done.
Mm-hmm.
The creation, flowers, activities, events.
Amusement
as well, yes.
Right. And at one time, I didn't know that we're supposed to enjoy life. I just thought it was all about going to church, going to work, going back home, and, you know, not enjoying life like this. I just thought, you know, he didn't want us to enjoy life down here on the earth, but I found out that he did.
Yes, he does.
That's right.
So we thought it was all sacrifice.
Right, sacrifice. Right.
Sacrifice this, mm-hmm. sacrifice this, mm-hmm. sacrifice this, sacrifice that.
Exactly.
Church in, church out. you know, that's all we do.
Right.
And then we wonder why sometimes we just lose hope.
Hope, right.
And we have little desires in our thing, mm-hmm. in our heart that we want to do, but we so timid about mentioning them because maybe it's not spiritual.
That's right.
Maybe if I mention I want to take a vacation, mm-hmm. maybe if I take, I mention I want to have a boat or mm-hmm. a motorcycle or do some things.
Right.
You know, that's not, I don't want it unless God wants it.
Right.
Well, God's not going to ride the bike.
Right.
He's not, you know, the bike is for you. He'll be with you to protect you on
right.
it. But he's concerned about what you like. Do you like red or blue or purple bike? What do you like? And some things that one person may like, I might not like.
You might not like, that's right.
See,
mm-hmm.
I may like a boat. You may like a motorcycle.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I prefer the boat. The other person might prefer the motorcycle. But God said, I want you to just enjoy life, and I'm going to give you things.
Mm-hmm.
But I want you to know what's in your heart. What is it that you really want? And you had to be honest with yourself.
Right.
And, you know, because God already knows.
Yeah, he knows. Yeah, he
and
knows.
It's nothing like getting those things in life mm-hmm. that you want after so long. You know, you said, man, it's just a wonderful thing mm-hmm. to be here on this vacation and to joy myself or to be doing this or that. Mm-hmm. You know, and you're still serving God.
You're still serving God, right.
But this is all a part of it. Mm-hmm. So that's the part we want you to know in St. John 10:10. I came mm-hmm. that you may have life and enjoy it. Right. Enjoy it.
In abundance, too.
In abundance. Mm-hmm. He's going to make sure you have enough to enjoy the mm-hmm. trip, where you don't have to worry about being restricted on your money because you want to save this for your BG&E bill or your right. gas electric bill so you can't enjoy the vacation. Mm-hmm. No, you have enough to pay that. I have enough left over.
That's right.
I mean, he has just totally supplied your life.
That's right.
Now, let's look at, to get back to, let's look over to the book of Psalms. The book of Psalms, chapter, 37? Mm-hmm. Yeah, Psalms 37. And we're going to begin reading at verse 4. Okay, let's read verse 4, yes.
Psalms 37, verse 4. Delight thyself also in the Lord, and he shall give thee the desires of thy heart.
Mm. Delight yourself mm-hmm. in the Lord. Delight yourself in me. Mm-hmm. In other words, you can put it this way. The Lord is saying, let me be your delight.
That's right.
Let me be the one who delights you. You know, some things are so delighted to have. And when you're delighted with something, you're just happy with it. It's something that you desire. Mm-hmm. It's something that you are pleased with and happy to have and to be a part of, because you just enjoy it. It's like when you're eating a ice cream, you can see how they're so delighted about it, about what the expression on their face,
that's right.
The response.
That's right, how fast they're eating it.
Yes, how so much good. Of it they're eating. Right. You when someone is delighted about something, you can see the expression, mm-hmm. the appreciation, and the glow. They just happy to be here. That's like when you come to church, you ought to be delighted to come. Mm-hmm. And just like in a relationship, when someone is delighted to be with you, mm-hmm. and they delight themselves in you, they express their excitement and that's their right. appreciation of you, that you're not just some bother or mm-hmm. some person you had to tolerate. Mm-hmm. But I'm delighted to be here. And he said, if you right. delight yourself in me, mm-hmm. right?
Right.
Delight yourself in me.
And I'll give you the desires of that heart.
I'll give you desires of whose heart?
Your
heart. Now, is there something? Mm-hmm. So God is concerned, what's in your heart?
That's right.
I will give you the desires of your heart. Now the thing is, what do you desire? What that's is it right. you want in life?
Well, what is it that you have great pleasure that you want?
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I could think about a lot of things that I want, you know, that I was afraid to ask God, because that's just, I'm not sure if he can do that for me. But we have desires, and he wants us to tell him our desires.
Yes.
You know, so.
Just like if you believe in God for a mate, and mm-hmm. you may say, Lord, just send me a mate. Okay, well, how would you like them
that's
to
right,
be?
How would you like them?
Oh, any way you fix them, any way you bless me, I'm satisfied. That's so general. He said, but no.
Yeah.
Do I don't want to give you something you don't like, and that's you right. take it because I like it, but you don't.
That's right.
Do you want them 6 feet,
that's right,
4 feet tall?
Kind of close to your age? Or,
right.
Right. Or you want them
thick? Thin?
Right.
What is it that you like? And I'll be honest with you, as Christians, even though we're born again, but there are certain things that brings delight to us mm-hmm. when we see it.
That's right.
And there are some things that don't.
Mm-hmm.
What you may like, I might not like. We don't have to like the same things, because like some people may like a certain vehicle set with these flashy wheels.
Right.
I may not like them sparkling wheels, that's but right. you may like them, mm-hmm. those rims. Mm-hmm. I like something more in a different, you know, perspective mm-hmm. than
yeah,
that.
Some people like cars 4 doors, but some people want 2 doors.
Some want 2 doors.
A sport.
Mm-hmm. Yes, a sport model.
Mm-hmm.
Some like motorcycles. Some like trucks.
That's right.
You know, so Pastor Don, what does that have to do with anything about serving God? It has nothing to do about serving God, but these are the benefits from serving God.
From serving God, that's right.
See, these are the things, this kind of God we serve, mm-hmm. he said, I will give you the desires of your heart. If you delight yourself in me, obviously God knows you have some desires.
That's right. We all have desires. Everybody has desires. Sometimes we just don't say nothing about it, but we got them.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a sad thing when you don't have no desire for at all. Mm-hmm. I mean, even if you desire the wrong thing, it's still a desire.
That's right.
You know, mm-hmm. but God said, I'm concerned about your desires, and I want to give you the desires of your heart.
That's right.
And I always desired to have an automobile, because when I grew up, there was never an automobile in the house. I didn't grow up in a home where my parent had an automobile and we could just go out and drive play. I said, so one day I'm going to have me an automobile. One day I want to have a car. I want my own car. And I was envisioning it. I was thinking about it. This is before I got saved. Mm-hmm. But I know it was important that I got born again first. But once I got born again, I didn't lose that desire. Mm-hmm. I still wanted that, right. And God knew I wanted it.
Right.
Till one day it came to pass because it was something that I anticipated mm-hmm. on having.
Yeah, that's just like, you know, a married couple, that if they desire to have a child, they want a child, then they tell God. You know, and then some people don't want none. Then you tell God you don't want none, you know?
Well, you don't have to.
You don't have to. Everybody's not the same.
No. Mm-mm. He's concerned about your desires and the things you want. Mm-hmm. Because, matter of fact, there's a very familiar scripture here, Sugar, in Mark 11. Mm-hmm. Look at in Mark chapter 11, verse 24. And I'm going to tell you something, folks. There are some things I'm expecting God to do. I'm expecting from God. Mm-hmm. And I don't know about you, but I know God is a good God. Well, you, Pastor Don, do you know how to what's going on in the world? And I'm not looking for that. That's not going to erase what God wants from me and what
I want.
That's right. See, I'm not going to look at that and say, oh, well, I might just forget it because the economy is down. Mm-hmm. Everything is bad, you know, and we're going through a pandemic and all of that. Well, still, my desire is to get through it. Mm-hmm. Also, at the same time, I'm not going to throw away my desires and the things I had before it came, because that is not going to take what God has placed in my heart and the desires I had.
Right.
There are some things I'm expecting from God in my own personal life as far as ministry, as far as marriage. A lot of things I'm looking forward to happen, places to go, and I'm going to get there because he didn't bring us this far to call us to in the middle.
That's right.
But we're going to cross over to the other side. We're going to get there because mm-hmm. it's in our view and we see it. See, look at Mark 11, 24. Mark chapter 11, verse 24.
And it says, therefore I say unto you, what things soever ye desire. See the word desire?
Mm-hmm.
When ye pray, believe that ye receive them and ye shall have them.
Now see that?
Mm-hmm.
And it says here, what things soever you desire.
That's right. You ask.
Right. Whatever you ask and what mm-hmm. you desire. You know, God has keep putting a desire on us. Mm-hmm. What do you want, Don?
Mm-hmm.
Well, you there praying all around. God said, look, tell me what you want.
That's right. Make it specific. Make it known.
Specific. That's the mm-hmm. thing.
Make it specific.
See that?
Mm-hmm.
Be specific about what you want. Just go ahead and tell the Lord, you know, I'd like to have this. I'd like to do that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I want to one day be a part of that company.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I want that promotion. I want to do that. I want to be this type of person, mm-hmm. this type of individual. You know, I want to be a successful in a certain way so I can be a blessing.
Right.
You know, these are my desires. Mm-hmm. He says, then what things so you desire, Don, mm-hmm. or you put your name there, when you pray, mm-hmm. believe
right.
that you receive them. Them what? Them things you desire.
That's right. But you got to believe.
You got to believe.
Believe that you receive them.
Believe mm-hmm. you receive it. So
you shall have them.
And you shall have them. So he's not holding back on us, is he?
He's not holding back.
He wants you to have the desires
yes, he did.
Of your heart. He wants those things there in your heart mm-hmm. to have. He said, now, Sugar, when you think about this,
mm-hmm.
we're not flipping the script, but God is saying, okay, I know you, my will is important,
mm-hmm.
but also I want to know what's in your heart.
What's in your heart?
What do you want?
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes you just say to the Lord, some things you have to say, okay, well, Lord, I know everything is not my way.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you know, it's, everything is not my way. Because the scripture here and says, and look at Proverbs a minute. Because once you get born again, you don't ask crazy stuff. Now that your heart has changed, you're not just going to ask God to do this or do that. You know it's not even scripturally right.
But it has to be in his will.
Yes. Mm-hmm. You know, so you're going to, our heart has been changed. We don't ask ridiculous mm-hmm. stuff. You know, right. crazy stuff and all of that. Three and four wives. So ask God, give me a three-word
wife. Right. Somebody already married.
You know, something crazy. No, you don't do stuff mm-hmm. like that. But look at Proverbs here, chapter 11. Proverbs chapter 11. And look at verse number 23. Proverbs 11, 23.
Mm-hmm. The desire of the righteous is only good, but the expectation of the wicked is wrath.
You see that?
Mm-hmm.
But the desire of the righteous, mm-hmm. that's us who are born again, it's only good. See, so God trusts your desires.
That's right.
Of the righteous. He said, the righteous man will desire the things that are of God.
Mm-hmm.
He's not going to desire things outside of God.
Mm-hmm.
So God is saying, tell me what your desires are. You know, because the desire of the righteous is only good. Mm-hmm. I desire to be a blessing in the kingdom. Mm-hmm. I desire to reach the lost. I desire to share what God has given me with others. I desire to take a vacation. Mm-hmm. I desire to enjoy myself.
That's right.
I desire to have enough money, and not just enough, but more than enough.
Right.
I want to do that. I want to have these things. Mm-hmm. See, things. now let me say that, things. Now, God wants you to have some things, right?
Right.
He has promised us things to have. And you may say, Pastor Don, well, do we need things? No, but God just wants you to have some things to enjoy yourself
That's
with.
Right.
He said, if that jet ski will bring some enjoyment to you, then I want you to have. Enjoy mm-hmm. yourself on it. Don't sit on that jet ski and just cry.
That's right.
And be sad. Enjoy. I want to give you these things to enjoy.
Enjoy. That's right. Because the righteous, we can look forward to a reward.
Yes.
That's right, because God will reward us and whatever we desire, he will give it to us, you know, because we are, you know, the righteousness of God. So we
yes.
get it.
So we will get
we
it.
We will get it.
And, you know, I believe God enjoys himself when he's seeing us enjoying ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
It brings him joy. He takes pleasure in the prosperity of his servants.
He does.
The scripture says, he said, I take pleasure when my servants prosper and enjoy themselves. And so he's just excited about it,
mm-hmm.
as more than what you realize that he is.
Mm-hmm.
When you enjoy yourself and you do some things, you know, some people think because we're Christian, we just go to church, pray,
mm-hmm.
fast, and just suffer.
Right.
It's not all to that. Those are part things we do.
Right.
And we enjoy that because we delight ourselves in God.
Right.
But also we have recreational things we do too.
Mm-hmm. That's right. Mm-hmm.
You know,
yeah, we like sports and
yes.
just don't put none of that stuff before God.
Don't put it above God.
God, right.
See, matter of fact, you mentioned that. Sugar. Let's go to 1 Timothy.
Okay.
1 Timothy chapter 6. Yeah, 1 Timothy chapter 6. And he talks about that in the 17th verse.
Mm-hmm.
1 Timothy chapter 6, verse 17. And it says about all.
He said, charge them that are rich in this world.
In this world. You can be rich in this world.
World, that's right.
Right.
That they be not high-minded.
Now, not rich, but just not high-minded.
Right.
Not high-minded, not puffed up.
That's right.
Not high-minded.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Nor trust in uncertain riches, but in the living God, who giveth us richly all things to enjoy.
Now, he gives us richly mm-hmm. all things to enjoy.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't that something?
Mm-hmm.
Now, he said, charge them that are rich in this world that just don't be high-minded. Don't be puffed up in it, right? Or don't trust in uncertain riches. We don't put our trust in riches or in things.
Or money.
Yeah,
or we don't put our trust in money.
No, mm-hmm. no. Nothing material.
Mm-mm.
Our trust in the living God.
In living God, who give us richly all things to enjoy.
Giveth mm-hmm. us richly, lavishly,
mm-hmm.
all things to enjoy. Now, you may say, well, he already have one item. Why does he need a second one? Well, God said, I just want to throw that in there extra.
Mm-hmm.
You see, that's how God does it.
Right.
I only asked for one. God gave you two.
Okay. Let me read this in the Amplified.
Mm-hmm.
They got a little bit more understanding.
Mm-hmm.
And it says, as for the rich in this world,
mm-hmm.
charge them not to be proud
mm-hmm.
and arrogant and contemptuous
mm-hmm.
of others, nor to set their hopes on uncertain riches,
mm-hmm.
but on God, who richly and gracefully provides us with everything for our enjoyment.
For our enjoyment.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't that something?
Yes.
So, for he give us things to enjoy ourselves with.
Yes.
Well, some say, I don't want no things. No, God wants you to have these things.
Mm-hmm.
And we enjoy ourselves with things.
Right.
See?
Mm-hmm.
A nice house is not a person, it's a thing.
It's a thing, right.
And he wants you to enjoy yourself with that thing, that house. A motorcycle is a thing.
Mm-hmm.
A boat is a thing.
Right.
Whatever, you look at some little jewelry you have that's nice, that's a thing. Nice clothes, that's a thing. Taking a nice trip, that's something you are doing to enjoy some things
that's
on.
That's right.
You don't have to have it,
mm-hmm.
but he said, I'm going to give you. Well, I went on vacation this year, Pastor Don. God said, I want you to take another one because I just want you to enjoy yourself.
That's right.
Enjoy yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Enjoy your life.
Mm-hmm.
God said, I've given you richly all these things to enjoy yourself with. And I said, man, Lord, you're concerned about me being enjoying my life, right? Yes, I want you to enjoy yourself on your way coming to heaven. I want you to experience some excitement. I want to know what's in your heart. I want to know what you desire. I want to know what you want, because I want you to have it. And man, I'm telling you, folks, I don't love money, but I enjoy having it. Because 2 Timothy 6 says, the love of money is the root of all evil, not money itself. So I don't love
it's
money.
The love of it.
Right. I don't love it.
Money.
Don't worship it, because it's uncertain riches. That's not God. But you enjoy having it. You know, you enjoy when you can go somewhere, you can, pay for it. And know once you pay for it, you're not paying for it with your life. You're just paying for it, you know, with the little bit of money.
Right.
You have somebody else, oh, that's paid for, paid off. I can pick this one. I can choose. If I stay at this nice hotel then, that's nice. I can pick that room. Or when I ride and take a flight, I can ride what class I want to ride in.
First class.
You know.
Right.
Even if you don't get the first class right away, at least get on the plane and start.
Get on the plane. That's right.
You know, that's a start. I enjoyed that. Right. You know, and I'm enjoying my health. Enjoying peace.
Right. Because at one time, I really didn't enjoy football, but now I do. I enjoy watching it, but I'm not going to put football, you know, over God. But I look at it, you know, when children. At the church,
But you enjoy watching the game.
I enjoy it. I enjoy watching.
And you know me, I didn't listen to no sport or watch no sports. Now recently, I'm starting to watch some sports and things, and especially football. And I enjoy myself. I enjoy watching it, especially when we win. I really enjoy it.
And watching them run up and down, the field. I enjoy it.
Right, and it's good to be there. You know, I would think the Bible speaks about enjoy the wife of thy youth. So you ought to enjoy each other.
That's right. Enjoy each other.
Not endure each other. Enjoy.
Right.
You should do things that you both can have some enjoyment.
That's right.
That helps that and strengthen that relationship and that marriage because we're enjoying this. You know, we're enjoying ourselves. And sometimes you need to go out and enjoy yourself go out to some places. And don't just limit it to the season that we're in now, because we're talking past that. I'm not talking about no restrictions and all of that. I mean, I'm talking about life itself, because God has a way of helping us to enjoy whatever season we're in.
That's right.
We can do it. See, because of course, having Him, He chose us. He said, I'm going to provide this for you. I want to provide that. And I'm expecting more in my life. I'm expecting more things. And God has given us things to help other people with.
That's right.
See, that's right. Okay. So we express our love through things. When many times someone gives you something, they share what they have with you.
That's right.
Because God used those as tools. See, so I just want to enjoy myself. And I really want you to enjoy yourself. It bothers me when someone that's close to me is sad or despondent. I don't want to see anyone like that.
No.
And before we got born again, we suffered that long enough, and we were in times we had no expectation. We had nothing to look forward to, but now we can look to God, and He said, Don, now I want you to look to me and expect things from me.
That's right.
Now, here's another scripture too, Sugar.
Okay.
In Psalms, I think that was 62. In Psalm 62. Because I'm looking to Him as my provider. And don't put your hope or your trust in people.
No, don't do that.
Don't look to them. Look to God. And I established these scriptures in my own heart, because some people just have their own interests at heart. They're not really concerned about with you. As long as they're enjoying themselves, they're not worried about you. But, I'm like this. Why should I waste my time worrying about them and that one, and they're not even thinking about me?
That's right.
I said, hey, I'm going to enjoy myself. I plan to be on this earth for a long time. A long time until my time of departure is at hand. I don't want to go before then. But in the meantime, I want to enjoy myself. And it says here in Psalm 62, verse 5.
My soul, wait thou only upon God, for my expectation is from Him.
My expectation is from Him. So my soul wait only on God. And that's what I'm waiting on to bring to pass what mm-hmm. I want. I'm not looking to man. I'm not saying God won't use me.
Right.
But I'm not expecting it from you, because if I do that, I set myself up for disappointment.
For failure, yeah.
Yes. But I look to God.
Look to God.
And I'm expecting something from him. Mm-hmm. But I know it's only a matter of time. If I delight myself in the Lord,
that's right.
He will give me the desires of my heart.
That's right.
Because he's the one who wants to give it to you.
Mm-hmm.
So if I delight in God, if I let him be my expectation, when I read the word of God, it's a delightsome thing.
Exactly.
It's no longer a thing. Mm-hmm. Or I better do it because God's going to be mad. No, I'm delighted to do it. You know, when I can pray and talk to the God of the heavens and earth, mm-hmm. the God of the universe, I'm delighted to do it. See, and God said, when you delight in me, man, I'm going to reward you and I'm going to give you the desires of your heart.
Right. And when you think about that, and you know, God will reward us and give us the desires of our heart. And then you say, well, you know what? He's not no mean God. You know, he wants us to have things down here on the earth and enjoy life.
He wants us to.
But at one time, I didn't think like that. You know, I really didn't think like that. But now I'm just so glad that I learned some scriptures about desires that, you know, I can believe and trust God, you know, that he does want me, you know, to have some desires and have an enjoy life. You know, it's good to enjoy life. It really is.
It is.
Mm-hmm.
And he's concerned about your desires.
Yes.
You know, he wants to know what you want in life. And mm-hmm. he's concerned about that. You know, if you're in some type of dictatorship thing or some God is looking for faults and beating you down
right.
to judge mm-hmm. you, you know, that's not good. But he said, look, well, how do you feel? God said, what do you want? What are you looking for? What is in life you want to have? Because mm-hmm. I want to help you get there.
That's right.
I'm concerned. Because I want you to have just as much as you want to mm-hmm. have it. You know, I know you're serving me. I know you're following me. And that's why I thank God for those servants of God that are laboring in the kingdom, feeding the flock, ministering to, and especially these seasons that we're in now.
Mm-hmm.
God is our provider. He's your provider. You know, and God labors. He rewards your labor. You know, because some say, well, Pastor Don, I've been in this ministry and I've been in this and been in that. And since I don't have this and that, and I've been pastoring or whatever you've been doing. And you may think it's a negative side, but mm-hmm. no, because God takes care of you. He wants to reward you for your labor. And he wants you to enjoy yourself. You don't just mm-hmm. pastor, and labor without mm-hmm. no enjoyment.
That's right.
You know, I mean, I thank God for our church, our household of faith family. I really appreciate every one of them. They how they respond to us and mm-hmm. just they want to see to it that we enjoy ourselves.
That's right.
The support and everything. And I never take that for granted, because all of that means a lot. And because I'm going to tell you something. We're in a time now where if you will trust God, you can still enjoy your life.
Right.
Because what you see today, one day is going to be the thing of the past.
Thing of the past. That's right.
Be a thing of the past.
And you had to think about, oh, that did happen.
Yeah. Yeah.
Right.
It'll be a thing of the past.
Uh-huh.
See that?
Uh-huh.
Let's look at St. John 5 a minute. St. John 5. No, 15, Sugar. St. John chapter 15. And I said to myself, my expectation is from God. And why? Because if somebody else get mad at you, they said, I'm going to hold back and give it now.
Right.
They said they were going to do it. And uh-huh. then they said, well, you didn't do what I want you to do for me. So now I ain't going to give it to you.
Uh-huh.
So I said, okay, well, I guess if I was looking to man, it'd be over.
It'd be over. That's right.
But
that's why you can look to God.
Psalm 62, mm-hmm. we just read that. You know how he said my expectation is from him only.
That's right, him only.
He is my rock,
mm-hmm.
and he's going to meet my need.
Mm-hmm.
He knows exactly what I want in life. He knows the person that's best for me. He knows
that's
the
right.
job that's best
right.
for me.
That's right. He knows.
He knows the state to mm-hmm. live in, whether mm-hmm. geographical area is best for me. And some people desire to live other places
mm-hmm.
and other states and live in a mm-hmm. certain type of house. He want to know that. You know,
mm-hmm.
I'm not. There's some log cabins that are very nice, but I don't want that. I don't know how nice it is, but there is somebody who wants it.
Somebody who wants it.
And you may like that.
Yeah,
some people like the wilderness
that's
and
right.
out there in the wilderness and
right.
All of that stuff. They like that. You know, mm-hmm. I'm not much on that. I like outdoor adventure, but I want to live somewhere nice, even better than that.
Right.
And I'm thank God for where I'm at now, because where mm-hmm. I'm living now, you know, I wasn't living like this years ago.
Right, right. But you know what? I had a desire, because the street I was living on was real busy, and I told God, I said, I do not never want to live on a busy street. And so the street now we live on is like a cul-de-sac, and we don't live on a busy street.
Very seldom you see anything.
No, I know only who lives in that block comes up there most of the time, but Yeah, and that was a desire that I asked him for.
And that's fine.
Mm-hmm.
And some may like a nice tall condominiums. They right. like them. That's okay. That's mm-hmm. they said, Lord, I desire that. He said, okay, right. that's what you want, then believe me for it. And I'm going to get you into that.
That's right. And everybody don't desire the same thing. So
no,
don't
sure.
get mad at somebody if they like something different than you.
Mm-hmm.
That's their desire. And they have a choice to like what they want to like.
Right.
You know, once I learned that, I just said, okay, whatever you desire, whatever you like.
Yes.
Even if I don't like it, it's what you like.
It's what you like.
That's right.
You know, a lot of times mm-hmm. in a religious setting, we've been taught, you know, it's not about what you want, it's what God wants. It's not about what you want, it's what God wants. Mm-hmm. Now, I understand what you mean. That's true. Mm-hmm. Not my will, but thy will be done.
Mm-hmm.
But God is not a dominant God where he's not concerned about your wants, too.
Right.
He you know, he wants you to have some things you want. He's not leaving you out. That we just serving God and we have mm-hmm. no say-so about nothing. We can't ask him for it. No, he's our Father. He wants us to.
He wants us to.
And sad to say, there are some Christians who have dimmed their own life because they're not enjoying it.
Mm-hmm.
Not enjoying the church you're in or the marriage or the life. And tell life is just get up, go to sleep.
Yeah, go to work.
Go to work, home. Get a meal, routine.
Eat.
You know, nothing else. And then after that, let's go back to church.
Uh-huh.
You know, and let's go to and we'll take a vacation when the church has a trip.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, when church have a trip.
You know, then we all go get on the bus. We go on the church trust mm-hmm. trip bus and all that. And that's mm-hmm. fine. You know, that's a start.
That's
and I'm
start.
Not
right.
undermining that. Mm-hmm. But it's more. Sometimes you might just want a trip for you and your family individually.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Right? Mm-hmm. You might just want, you all want to go somewhere. Especially couples. You might not want to be all coupled up on, bunked up on the bus with everybody
yeah,
else.
That's right.
You and your wife might just say, let's just go somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
Let us do something together.
Mm-hmm.
Let's enjoy ourselves. And sometimes you may not know exactly where you're going to go that day. Get in your car, ride. You just look
That's
at the
right.
creation.
That's right.
Look at life.
Mm-hmm.
And just see how splendid God is and wonderful and how he has made things. And just enjoy yourself. And go and get yourself something nice to
right.
eat and enjoy yourself that day.
Right. Yeah, because sometimes we're just riding around and then there's some areas that I haven't even seen. Just in Baltimore, and I've been saying, this over here, I've never seen it, you know, or heard of it. Then I say, okay, they living good over here.
Right, it's, yeah. right. it's not all, there's some good in everything.
There's
if you
some
look
good
forward,
in everything, right.
You got to, right. St. John, now look at St. John 15:7. This is, 15:7. Yeah, St. John 15:7. We got about a few minutes left here, 5 minutes or so, but it says in 15:7, Sugar.
If ye abide in me and my words abide in ye, ye shall ask what ye will and it shall be done unto you.
Mm. So make me your dwelling place.
Mm-hmm.
Make me your habitation.
Mm-hmm.
If you abide in me and my words abide in you. So we're
right.
not putting the word of God out. We're not putting out our fellowship or our dwelling in fellowship with God. If you abide in me, my words abide in you.
Mm-hmm.
You ask what ye will. Now see,
you,
you will.
Will mm-hmm.
Well, Lord, I want what you will. Then he turns around and says, what do you will? Or you what you desire? God said, I will trust your desire of what you ask. Because I know your desire is going to be good because you made me your dwelling place
right.
and my words in you. So you're going to ask only the things that comes from my word
right.
that I already provided.
Mm-hmm. That's what
Man.
He already provided. Right.
So ask what you will. And it shall be done unto you. Praise God.
Praise God.
Lord, I want a vacation. You may say, I want to go to the Caribbean.
Mm-hmm.
And I want to do some deep sea fishing. You may say some stuff. You say, okay, well, God, so I'm going to fix that up for you. I'm going to put that on the list.
Mm-hmm.
Because a day is coming where you're going to have it. I want to take a cruise. Well, one day you're going to take one. One day I want to go to the Caribbeans or anywhere else you might like you want to go, or a flight, I want to go to the West Coast. So there are some parts of the earth I want to see that I have never seen before.
Mm-hmm.
I only seen it on pictures or on National Geographic, but one day I want to see it myself. Okay, you believe me for it. Believe me for it and go, because I want you to enjoy yourself.
Right.
Praise God. That is so beautiful. Amen. Praise God. Now we're going to close right quickly. We're going to give you two other scriptures here
mm-hmm.
in Proverbs. Look at Proverbs 13. And look at Proverbs chapter 13. And let's look at verse 19, Shuggy. Well, man, you know what? Look at verse 12 a minute, and then we'll go to 19.
13:12?
Yeah, 13:12.
Hope deferred maketh the heart sick, but when the desire cometh, it is a tree of life.
See that? When the desire cometh, it's a tree of life. Mm-hmm. But hope deferred makes the heart sick. What is hope deferred?
When a delay.
A delay.
Mm-hmm.
A delay. Yep. When the desire has not come.
Mm-hmm.
And you're saying, man, what, and God said, I don't want this thing delayed no more than what it has to.
Right.
Isn't that something? You know, who it's deferred. I want it here. And he said, that'll make you sick when mm-hmm. no desires don't come.
Mm-hmm.
But when it does come, it's like a tree of life. Right. He don't want your hope or your desire deferred mm-hmm. or delayed. He wants it to come to pass.
That's right.
Right?
And he'll then be very happy.
He'll be very happy.
Happy. That's right. You'll be very happy when it does.
Yeah, you and him.
That's right. You and him.
You and him will be very happy. Mm-hmm. Then the 12th verse. I mean,
that was the 12th.
Okay, the 6th. What I got here? The 19th.
The desire accomplished is sweet to the soul, but it is abomination to fools to depart from evil.
Mm. The desire accomplished is sweet. When that desire is accomplished, in other words, come to pass, it's a sweet
right.
thing.
When it's fulfilled.
That's a sweet thing.
Mm-hmm. It's a sweet thing.
And whose desire is yours?
Mm-hmm.
So when you get the desire that you have been looking for and mm-hmm. dreaming for, he has said it's a beautiful thing. I mean, you just enjoy it. It's mm-hmm. a wonderful thing
exactly.
to see it come to pass.
Mm-hmm.
And God wants to help you get that. He wants you to receive it and expect it and know that mm-hmm. that's his will for you to have
that's
the
right.
desires of your heart.
Mm-hmm.
So you need to get a pencil out and start writing some things down.
The desires you want.
The desires
that's
you
right.
want.
And you apply them and put these scriptures with it.
Yes. Mm-hmm. And expect them.
That's right.
I desire to see my family saved. That's a desire.
That's a desire, right.
You know, I desire to see my body well and strong.
Mm-hmm.
I desire that. That's a heart. That's your desire.
That's your desire.
You know, why is yours? Because some people don't want to see you well.
Mm-hmm.
But I do.
Mm-hmm.
See? I desire to have an abundance in my life mm-hmm. and no lack. So blessed that I can be a blessing.
That's right.
I don't have to, I can be the lender, not the borrower.
Oh, right.
I mean, abundantly supplied for. Mm-hmm. Praise God.
You can desire that for a car.
Design a vehicle.
Mm-hmm.
Well, he give us richly all things. God is involved in things,
mm-hmm.
so things aren't bad. So don't tell anybody to tell you that. Things are good. When you put them in the right place.
Right.
We don't worship them.
No, we don't worship them.
It's just good to have them.
Mm-hmm. It's good to have them.
Amen. Well, amen. We trust, praise God, you got
praise
something
God.
Out of the program mm-hmm. today, and we hopefully we spark your desires and refresh some of them that you put on the shelf that maybe you'll put them back up.
That's right.
And expect some great things for your life.
Uh-huh.
Because good things are headed our way. The best, like they say, is yet to come.
Mm-hmm.
So we know God has great things in store for us through everything else. Good days are ahead. They're right in front of us,
mm-hmm.
folks. So I'm expecting good things
me
from
too.
God. Amen.
Good things.
Now, if you're out there today and you're viewing the program, we never want to close our program without giving you the opportunity to receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. If you're not born again or you're not certain that you are, the most important thing is that you're saved. Because the Bible says, what shall it profit a man if he were to gain the whole world
mm-hmm.
and lose his soul? You don't want to lose your life.
You don't want to lose your life.
At all. And Christ doesn't want you to lose it. He wants you to have it. So you just pray a simple prayer and just say, Heavenly Father,
in Jesus' name. In
Jesus'
name.
Thank you. For sending Jesus.
To die on the cross.
For my sins.
For my sins.
I receive Jesus. As my personal Savior. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
For saving me.
I'm saved now.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
We rejoice with you. We rejoice with you. You on your road to victory and the blessing now, just right there. And of course, you can call that number on the screen and we'll definitely rejoice with you along with that and pray with you and believe God with you for any everything else that you may need prayer with. And also, we want to close in prayer today for all you who are viewing. We thank God for every one of you who have taken the time out to sit and enjoy these programs, and we trust that you are subscribing to our program and you are also telling others about
it.
That means a lot. That helps a lot for us so we can keep this gospel going across these airways through technology. We need your help, and we need you to stand with us and believe God with us. Amen. Praise God.
Amen.
Amen. So we're going to close out in prayer today and believe God.
Amen. Father, in the name of Jesus, we just come to you thanking you because you are our Lord and our Savior.
Yes.
Father, we come giving you all the glory, the thanksgiving, because we thank you for being our God. Now, Father, we have taught on the desires of the heart, so we just praying that everyone that have a desire will come to you with their desire, and you would delight them in their desire. So Father, we just thank you for everything that you have done, and praise your holy name, because we know that you are a forgiving God and a loving God, and we know that you're not harsh on us. So Father, we just thank you for just loving your children, loving your people, Lord, and we thank you and give you all the praise and the honor in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. God bless you.
God bless you.
And we'll see him again the next time.
Yes.
Bye-bye for the day.
Now can I hear you make some noise just shouting to God? Open your mouth tonight. God is faithful, and he's able to do anything is possible. On him you can depend. He's closer to you than any friend. Don't ever lose your trust in him. God is faithful. Faithful is our God. Hallelujah, Jesus. God is faithful. Faithful is our God.
God is faithful.
And he's able to do
anything is possible.